Pretty pumped about today's video. I'm going to share with you how to create a pop art photo like this one. So if you want to learn how, stick around and I'll show you. Hey everybody, what's going on? Claudio here and welcome to my channel. I am Claudius, where I share tips and tricks on how you can share your story. As I mentioned at the beginning, I'm going to share with you how you can create a really cool looking pop art photo. We're going to take a selfie. I'm going to show you one that I took here and convert it, adding colors to it, creating quadrants. I'm going to show you how to do that using an app called Adobe Spark Post that everyone can do either on your phone or on a computer, laptop, Chromebook, Mac, PC, whichever one you have. So let's go ahead and get started. I've launched Adobe Spark Post on my computer here. I'm going to tap on create a project and use a custom size graphic here. I'm going to go ahead and go with what's the default there. I want to use a square format. It's going to work best for this four color quadrant. Click on next and I'm going to add that photo. Now I converted it to black and white. I think it's going to look better. It's going to work better if we choose a black and white photo. So if yours is color, you can adjust it in here or you can convert it to black and white in any photo software that you have on your phone. So here we have my selfie. That's the one I'm going to be using. And let's bring it into Adobe Spark Post. I want to make sure and pin it to the background. We're going to be doing this step four times. We're going to add the image again so that I can have four images of myself. Let me add several more here. My next step is to convert the layout. I'm going to be choosing a 4x4 layout here so that every square is the same size. My next step is to take each image in each of these quadrants and scale them up, make them about that large scale wise in each one. So I'm going to adjust it as close as I can get. This is going to take a little bit of play here. You want to get it as close as you can and make some minor adjustments as you start to move these images. What I'm going to do now is take this one here and I'm going to kind of puzzle these together. You can see it's kind of taking a shape here. So there we go. And as I mentioned, it might need some adjustments here. Scale it just a little bit bigger so that it's as close as it can be. Again, it's going to take a little bit of play. My glasses there are a little bit off. One more tiny adjustment here and I think we'll be just right. There we go. And you can use objects like ball caps, glasses, if you have some on, to help with the adjustments. Now that I have the four cells combined looking like the original image, I'm going to click on one of the cells and be careful not to move it. Click over to the filters menu and go over to colorize. What you want to do is do this to each of the cells, colorize it, and then shuffle it. I'm going to do this one, colorize it, shuffle it. Next one, colorize and shuffle. And then this one here, I'm going to go over to the multiply option. And the reason I'm doing this is because I'm only able to colorize shift with three colors. So I want to make this one slightly different and come up here to the enhanced photos, make a couple of adjustments here to that one so that I can tell that there's four different colors. And that right there is my pop art photo. So I can do some further adjusting by colors by clicking over here in the gray area and then coming over here to colors. You have all the different, thematic colors. You can go to the decorative looking ones, modern, but I'm going to come on here to the bold themes and click on any of them. And you can see how it shifts around, shuffle them until you get the one that you like. I like that one's pretty cool right there. go through the different ones, pick the one you like. Then when you're ready, just go over to the download option, download it as a PNG, JPEG, or PDF, start the download, and you'll have your own pop art photo. And here is my downloaded pop art photo. And that's how easy it is to create your very own pop art photo using Adobe Spark Post. I hope you've enjoyed this video or learned something new. If you have any questions or comments, do add it in the comment section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel if you haven't done so, and click on the bell to be notified for future videos just like this one. Keep creating out there, and as always, be very good to one another. Peace. I'm out.